Don't you love it when you have all of your pattern pieces cut out and you are ready to sew? That's where I am on this top that I decided to make, which is the Agnes top from Tilly and the Buttons. I've made this before, but I wanted to make it again. And actually, I think the first one that I made was a little bit too big, so I decided to cut a size 3 this time. The first time I had cut a size 4. So I'm going down in size. I'm also going to make the plain sleeve this time. So there's one that has the gatherings at the sleeve, but this time I just want to do a plain sleeve, and then I'm going to crop the sleeve so that it's a little bit short. I don't want it to go all the way down. And I found this fabric from Hobby Lobby, and I really like it. It's super soft. It feels so good. And of course, it's some type of animal print. I made some pants out of this fabric already that I really love, and that is what inspired me to make the top, because I couldn't find anything in my wardrobe to go with the pants. So I was like, okay, well, I guess I'll just make a top to go with it. So yes, I will have a nice, comfortable, like, set. I hope it won't look like pajamas, but we'll see. So hopefully in this video, I will be sharing with you my animal print set. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started on this make, which should not take me very long because there aren't very many pieces. So you have the front, the back, the sleeves, and the neckband. Oh, and also I did decide to lengthen the hem about an inch. So I wanna be able to tuck the top inside of my pants and then like pull it out a little bit just so it can kind of hang over a little bit. So that's what I have in my mind, and that's what I'm thinking I want to do with this top, so we shall see. So I basted the neckband on, and now I'm going to go ahead and serge it on so that it will be more permanent, because it's just basted at the moment. And I didn't have to adjust. I wanted to make sure it was going to go in okay, and it went in just fine. So I'm moving to the next step. Okay, there is the neck band, and it's all serged on. I need to clean up some of these threads, but these are my markings. That's my A for the back, because I find that it's so hard to make a B. Sometimes, like when I used to use chalk, I could never get the B. So I just started doing A, which is the next letter, BACK. So I just put the A, and so now every time I mark the back, I put a letter A instead of a B. Even though with the marker I could get the B in there, but I'm just so used to putting the A, I just keep doing that. And here is the finished product. I just need to press it. But this is it, all done. So I have my little two-piece set on, and I have been lounging in the house in this thing all day. I love it. It is so comfortable. So I want to share with you what the pants are. The pants are McCall 7061. It is an older pattern, and I made view F. I think the pants are view F, yeah. And they're really simple. This would be a great pattern to make for a beginner. I think both of them will be. The pants, they don't have any pockets. They don't have any elastic or anything like that. They do have a band across the waist, and then they have the little band around the ankle. I wanted to say a cuff, but I think it's more like a band to go around the ankle. And yeah, they're really, really easy. So I think that this would be a great pair of patterns to put together to make a really nice, comfortable outfit. So I'm happy with this, and hopefully you like it and maybe will be inspired to maybe even create your own. Okay, so I will show you what the two pieces look like together. And like I said, they're really comfortable. I did mention that I wanted the shirt to kind of hang over the top of the pants, but when I tried that, I did not like the way that it looked. So I found that I liked it most when the shirt was kind of just tucked all the way in as far as I can get it to, you know, go into the pants comfortably. So that is how I decided to wear this outfit. So that is it. It's super comfy and I like it. All right. I did want to share three patterns with you. I put two fingers, but three patterns. Two of these patterns are patterns that I have decided that I don't think I will ever make, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of them. So I just wanted to share that. The first one is Butterick 6021. And I bought this pattern because I really liked View A, but I don't think I will ever sew it, so I'm going to just donate this. The other pattern that I will be donating is Simplicity 8015. I think that this dress is really cute, and I thought that I was going to make View C, the one that's in white. I think that's white. But every time I go through my patterns, I always thumb through those or these two. And so I just said, you know what? I don't think I'm ever going to make these. So let me just go ahead and donate them and give them to someone that may be interested in actually sewing these up. So the other pattern that I want to share is a pattern that I purchased recently on Etsy. It's a coat pattern that I thought was really interesting. This is Berta, what number? 3342. And the coats A and B, I think, are the same, but one is just a little bit longer, but otherwise they're the same construction and everything. So I am interested in making the shorter version, which is the one in red. So yes, I purchased this and I really like this one too. It has a separating zipper, and I don't think I've ever done a separating zipper. So I thought that that would be interesting to give a try. So before I go, I want to leave you with a love share. So you may know this already, not too sure, but this morning I learned that breakdancing will be an Olympic sport in the year of 2024. What?